views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
The following audio is via a Skype call.
Welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio, harnessing our connection with the universe to affect change for optimal success and happiness. Are you looking for direction with your relationships, business, purpose, or simply life? Well, you're at the right place. Named one of the country's top psychics, Eve now brings her insights and gifts to this weekly hit call-in show, joined by visionaries, leaders, gifted others, but mostly you. Get ready for a slice of life's journey, Eve's objective guidance, tarot, readings, and the momentum you need to move beyond whatever crossroad you're stuck at. Now here's your amazing host, Eve.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio, harnessing the power of the universe for happier living. Good morning, West Coast. Good afternoon, East Coast. And good day, Australia. My name is Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. So happy about today's show. Benny, thank you for throwing out the opening pitch. And many thanks to one and all for tuning in. Okay. So this East Coast weather is totally wild. Here we are in April, and just this week, we've had forecast highs in the 70s and lows with predicted 8 to 12 inches of snow. Yesterday, it was a high of 68. Today, 31. I'm indoors, thankfully. Ready to do readings all hour today if you're interested in receiving some guidance, clarity, and insight on whatever may be blocking your way right now. Give me a call. Today, I am doing a not one, not two, but a three-card tarot card reading with the first card representing your current situation, second card representing something challenging or blocking you, third card representing advice. The phone lines are open. The number to call for a reading is 800-930-2819. That's 800-930-2819. If you would like some additional clarity on your path, a tarot card reading can be really helpful. Perhaps you've been feeling disconnected from your purpose, finding love elusive, and wondering what you can do within your own power to change the situation. We can look at all of this through the lens of the tarot card reading today. So give me a call. If you're hesitant, though, to get a tarot card reading because of those fear of scary cards, fear not. Sometimes those scary looking cards are actually the best cards. In fact, there are no bad cards in tarot, particularly as I only see tarot as a visual representation of the mind of the unconscious. Your unconscious is on your side, cheering you on, wanting you to be happy, wanting you to succeed, so nothing scary can possibly come up. Before I do any and every reading, I place a very clear boundary around the reading so that the cards that come up have one and one purpose only. They are there to provide guidance in addressing the question asked, but in a way where the person who's asking the question has tools they can use to tap into their own strength and power to find and pursue an optimal path forward. As always, please wait at least 3 weeks between readings if you've had a reading from me already, just to honor the universal energy that's been put forth for your reading so the messages do not become redundant and superfluous. That being said, I always love updates. For those tuning in for the first time wondering what in the world is this show, first of all, welcome. Just a little bit about me and my approach. I'm an intuitive coach and professional tarot card reader who works with clients worldwide on helping them tap into their own power to create change for optimal success and happiness. This is done through using energy effectively, using that which is in your power. That is my whole focus. It is my belief we are all surrounded by energy, and what can happen is that with career, love, or finding your purpose of passion, We sometimes, even with all the best of intent, find ourselves blocked with no movement forward. It feels at that point like you're pushing against the wind. This can be taxing to the mind, body, and spirit, and can be frustrating and lead to stress. There's that feeling it can develop about working twice as hard but only getting half as far. Through my work, I help clients with their own power move that energy to their back. So now they're only working half as hard but getting twice as far. By doing this, they are using energy effectively. I sort of liken myself to a vocal coach. It is so not my role to tell you to sing opera, Broadway, pop, or country. I just want you, with your glorious voice, to use your instrument effectively. I call myself the MBA psychic as, well, in addition to having an MBA, I look at a reading like an intuitive jigsaw puzzle where tools to affect change for optimal success and happiness are presented through the tapestry of the tarot card reading. My company, by the way, is Elite Tarot, which you can find at elitetarot.com, ElitetarotCom, or mainstreammetaphysicsradio.com. I do sessions over phone and Skype worldwide, so guidance and insight, no matter where you are, is just a click or call away. I do full profile readings, which take 60, 75 minutes, and we really go into depth about what might be blocking your energy, because sometimes it's a little surprising and counterintuitive. And then we look at how you, with your own power and strength, can shift that energy, so now you're embracing joy in whatever area of your life has been temporarily halted. I also offer shorter 30-minute phone readings where we look at fewer cards, but sometimes it's just what's needed to provide that guidance, clarity, and insight when you're facing a specific dilemma. All readings come with a summary of everything we talk about, photo of the final tarot card layout, recording of the session. Again, you can book a reading directly on my site at elitetarot.com. And in addition to individual readings, I also do tarot card readings at events nationwide for corporate retreats, birthday parties, bridal showers, wedding receptions, as well as I'm going to be launching soon some webinars. So you can get a little bit of everything from the comfort of your computer. So today I have a candle lit, which is my signal to open a session. And I'm going to be using the Rider-Waite Tarot Card Deck, which is the standard tarot card deck. And so if you don't have a deck handy, you can look the cards up online. Please ignore the stock interpretations. I'm just interested in the pictures. I will also describe them as best as I can. When you call, I'll be shuffling the deck while we chit-chat. Then I will be cutting the deck using my non-dominant hand, which is my left hand. I use the left hand, my non-dominant hand, because the non-dominant hand accesses the unconscious. After that, I'll be fanning the cards face down in front of me and using my non-dominant hand, run my hands along the back of the cards until three cards just energetically call out your name, practically literally sticking to my fingers, sort of saying, pick me, pick me, pick me. And as always, I do like to start with a small disclaimer. I am not a doctor, lawyer, therapist, travel agent, or realtor. And a tarot card reading should never be taken as a substitute for seeking guidance from a licensed professional. And finally, before we begin readings, these are just cards. They have absolutely no power over you. They're just pieces of cardboard. I certainly have no power over you. You always have free will. As the reading is a visual representation of the unconscious, it's just a visual representation of that little voice inside that we are always overruling. I do it myself. With a reading today, we're just saying, okay, little voice, tell me what you got to say. I may not follow it, but I want to hear an option. So we are going to take a quick break. When we come back, we've got readings to do. We've got phone lines open. If you're interested in a reading, give us a call at 800-930-2819. You are listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. We'll be right back.
stay juicy. Tune in to Your Juicy Love with me, Una Drake, co-hosting monthly with Dr. Pat, and every second Monday at 12 p.m. on Transformation Talk Radio. My show, Your Juicy Love, helps you find the dynamic, life-affirming love you've always wanted. Transform your relationships and bring peace, joy, and juicy, juicy love to planet Earth. For more information, visit unadrake.com.
Tune in to the Psychic Professor's Show, The Voices of Spirit Radio, with international medium and spirit artist Dr. Susan Barnes on Transformation Talk Radio. Featuring a variety of spiritual topics such as psychic art, spiritualism, EVP, psychic development, and mediumship. This hit call-in show provides listeners with breakthrough wisdom to enliven and enlighten their lives. Visit spiritartgallery.net.
Tune in each Friday, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern on Transformation Talk Radio.
Introducing New Soul Science, an introductory course with Ruby Betty, offering profound wisdom alongside radically simple concepts and techniques that collapse time, allowing instantaneous personal transformation. The foundational techniques of this introductory course reveal the profound inner ability each human has to access and fulfill their individual soul script or soul promise. Awakening this ability leads to the mastery of one's destiny. The concepts are totally original, immensely powerful, and completely revolutionary. They ignite an infinite fire within each listener, fueling one's ability to live out their unique soul promise. Are you ready to become more aware and access amazing personal transformation? This course is available now at rubybetty.co.
Be you plus live your purpose equals joy. That's the motto of Unstuck Joy with Vicki Todd. Vicki believes you were born with gifts that are meant to make the world brighter. Each show will feature an art visioning journal prompt to help you create your way to soul clarity. If you're ready to get unstuck and create more joy, this show is for you.
Tune in the first and third Tuesday at 3 p.m. Pacific on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit VickiWorldArt.com.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot, talking energy and doing readings today. Today, I am doing a three-card tarot card reading for callers. The first card representing your current situation, second card representing something challenging or blocking you, third card representing advice. If you're interested in a reading, give us a call at 800-930-2819. So before I get to calls, I just wanted to wrap up something that we've been talking about for the last few weeks, but we never actually finished it, on ways to use energy effectively to manifest joyful love. Particularly now, it's the spring season, love is in the air. So we started this a couple weeks ago, and just to recap briefly what we've already discussed, I started going through steps about what is in your power. The first step was to change the language immediately from joking about your single status to expressing hopelessness about ever finding love. From an energy perspective, these phrases are toxic. Every time you say one of these toxic statements, you create a heavy energy that weighs you down and makes it that much harder to get the very thing you desire. Habits are comfort-filled. The phrases and words are a habit, and they're safe. Changing a habit is so not easy. However, it can be done. The second step we talked about was to release any scripts that no longer serve you. We are all beings comprised of our past, both the positive and the challenging experiences. Bringing excess baggage into the dating process, however, can block our own energy. This makes it that much harder to achieve the joyful relationship that you want. We all have baggage from past relationships, negative self-talk, trauma, pain. Take the time now, before launching into the dating process, to heal and release wounds of the past. I always say that it's best if you can get your baggage to fit into the seat back in front of you. However, when we have to go to overhead bins or even check extra bags, it makes it that much harder to be vulnerable, open, and able to manifest love free of the baggage. If you'd like more tips and tools on these prior steps, please feel free to listen through the archives or through the podcast on iTunes. So, this brings us up to date, and here we get to the third step, which is to place your order with the universe. Most likely, you have a very clear list of what you're looking for in your head in terms of qualities, energies, looks, and so on in your next joyful relationship. However, it's important to transfer that information onto paper. So often when I have a client who's coming to see me about love issues, I'll ask them, do they have their list of non-negotiables written down? About 90% of the time, they will say they haven't written them down, but they are very clear in their mind about what they're looking for. The problem with this is that when the heart gets involved, qualities that they mentally see are non-negotiables can more easily be compromised. And some issues that have been compromised too many times already never get the priority that they deserve. By writing down your list of non-negotiable needs, you may find surprises. Perhaps what you think is key in your mind is not, for whatever reason, written down on paper. Alternatively, perhaps a quality you did not think was critical is written down first. Look and see as this information is data, key data for you to use. Now, before you write down your list, tap into your inner child when you write it down. I always say you're best served when your inner child's your GPS. However, do not worry, you still have the keys to the car. Think back to when you were younger, imagining the future love of your life. What qualities did that person have? Once you have your list, go through each one and ask yourself the following question. What if I meet the love of my life, but that person just doesn't have this particular quality? Would that be okay? If you answer yes, cross it off as that is a want and not a need. Your list should have no specifics. Blonde hair might be nice, but by putting it down on your list, you may be unintentionally putting up energy blocks. The universe may have someone who exceeds your expectations, but who has brown hair. Since you're clear that you want to meet someone with blonde hair, you might not be open or even see the person with brown hair. Instead, your list might have qualities such as loving, respectful, affectionate in public, ready for marriage, wants children, does not want children, financially stable, religious, not religious, and so on. These are not a list of wants, but rather non-negotiables that you need and will not compromise on. Your list will be different from that of everybody else on this planet. Leave it to the universe to do the heavy lifting in providing the specifics. By writing down a list of qualities without specifics, you open the door to more easily see and date someone that you might not have even considered before. Now, once you've written up your list, fold it up and put it away. Do not show your list to anyone. Now, as you go forward in the dating process, it's so much easier to see that when you come across those red flags. As I mentioned earlier, when the list is only in your head and not written down, red flags can be unclear as they're subject to interpretation, particularly when the heart is involved. This can then leave room for you to compromise on something that you really need. Your list, it's different from my list, it's different from Benny's list, it's different from Dr. Pat's list. The list is going to be unique just to you, and that's great. We are all on a unique journey. Your journey is completely yours and different from everybody else on this planet. So own those needs from that place of authenticity. Dating, it's a challenge. It's such a challenging thing at any age. But by using energy effectively and tapping into what is in your power, dating does not have to have the appeal of root canal surgery. Trust me. Rather, it can be one of adventure and strength. So again, if you missed those first two steps where I go into the steps one and two into depth, definitely check out the archives and you can hear it all over again. So I also wanted just, you know, since we're talking about tarot, I thought I would do is just go over a little bit about what this thing is. You know, so many people are saying, I don't know what this tarot thing is. So here's just a little bit of an overview. Now, if you're familiar with tarot, this stuff is going to be stuff you know already. But if you're not or just not sure when I talk about the different suits and everything, the major arcana, the minor arcana, hopefully this will fill in some blanks. So basically, a tarot card deck has 78 cards, not 52, but 78. But other than that, it has some similarities to your basic deck of cards. So those 78 cards serve as the archetypes of the human experience. They are all common experiences we can relate to and understand. Now, unlike the deck of cards where you've got the four suits, in tarot, there are five suits. Four of those suits are called minor arcana. And the fifth suit is what we call the major arcana. I like to look at the difference between these two groups sort of like a weather front, like I was talking about with the snow and the sun, trying to decide whether or not they should come into the window here. If a storm's coming, the minor cards might mean to ensure that you've closed your windows, you have enough eggs, you have enough water on hand, you got your milk. The major cards would be the weather. It's much more pervasive and you can't escape it. So in a tarot card reading, the major cards would be more about who am I? Where am I going? What do I stand for in this chapter? The minor cards would be more about what you do, those actual tangible actions that you put in place. So if I do a full reading and I get mostly minor cards, that alone is information. If some of the three card readings that I do today, they're all minor or all major, even before I go into what those cards mean, that tells you some information. Perhaps if it's only minor cards, the person might feel as if their dilemma is all consuming, but a few minor tweaks can actually make a world of difference. Now, if a reading has a majority of major cards, it's also information. It tells me that the person's going through a time of redefining themselves. And so with that, you may want to be a little bit more, give yourself some freedom to take some more time, as the solution or the remedy just might not be as straightforward. So how you break up those 78 cards is there's major cards, there are 22 of those, and then there's 56 of the minor cards. The minor cards are developed and they're split up into four suits: cups, wands, pentacles, and swords. So unlike, you know, the deck of cards where you got the ace through 10 and the jack, queen, king, in minor cards in tarot, you've got ace through 10, but then you also have page, knight, queen, king. The major cards are numbered 0 to 21 and have names like the magician, the fool, the world, wheel of fortune, the hermit. It's also in the major cards and a few minor cards where you see those scary looking cards. But again, I told you, nothing to be scared about. It's in the major cards where you get the death card, the devil card, the tower. So as I said earlier, I place a clear boundary around the reading. So even though it may look scary, sometimes those are actually the best cards. Similar to the fact that the death card has nothing to do with death and everything to do with change. The tower card also has stuff just to do with change. They just look a little bit scary on the outside. At the most core level, there are four minor suits represent four different aspects of life. Wands tend to talk about creativity, inspiration, ideas. Cups tend to talk about love, the heart. Swords tend to talk about analytical thought and action. And pentacles tend to talk about career. All those things, you know, again, if you get all pentacle cards, that's saying something. If it's all cups, it's also saying something. All of this, you kind of piece it together like a jigsaw puzzle. Taking in the four minor suits, if there's some card suit missing, that also is information. Maybe the person is missing some action. Maybe the person's missing some passion in their life. All of it is just, it's all different from each person. Please ignore the stock interpretations that you see just because it all is interpreted solely for you. So we are going to take another break. When we get back, we're getting to calls. Nancy, hang on. You're listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. We'll be right back.
Tune in to Synergenetic Living Radio, where Rick and Grace Paris discuss the synergenetic way of life, what it means to truly change your perspective in life, what it means to take control of your life and manifest your true desires. For more information on Rick and Grace Paris and Synergenetic Living, check out synergeneticliving.com. Get clear on the life you desire and the current life you are creating and what is between the two. Synergenetic Living, living life loud.
Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. I am so thrilled to be talking to all of you. We have got talk radio for all of us. Are you ready and willing and able to accept all of the abundance you can muster up in your life? Yes! Check us out at drpatshow.com, transformationtalkradio.com, transformationradio.fm. Oh my goodness.
Winning at the game of money. Lynn Brown is now offering Full Spectrum Finance, a progressive 12-month program that will help you to navigate through the mechanics of financial expansion. Finally, a financial planner who looks at the full spectrum of money and abundance. Engage you in the mental, physical, and energetic aspects of finance. This is Full Spectrum Finance. Are you ready to get into it? For more information, go to fullspectrumfinance.com.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Steffen each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Are you searching? Looking for a sign? A message you need to hear? From the great unknown? From the most mysterious place that is the most familiar to your soul and the depths of who you are? The universe put someone here to talk to. Someone God gave a blessing to that you may find insight with. TheAngelLady.net. 1-800-323-1790. 1-800-323-1790.
Ignite your inner magic on Grow Your Soul Radio with Jane Machanga. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio as host Jane Machanga explores how to overcome your fears to help you gain the inspiration you need to awaken your path to joy. Learn the way to life mastery and the enlightened path with Grow Your Soul Radio. For more information on Jane Machanga and her work, visit enlightened-path.com.
Oh, Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. If you'd like to learn more about me, book an intuitive coaching session over phone or Skype worldwide, or inquire about having readings at an event nationwide, please go to my website, elitetarot.com. That's ELITETAROT.com or mainstreammetaphysicsradio.com. So today, I'm ready to do readings. Today I'm doing a three-card tarot card reading with the first card representing your current situation, second card representing something challenging or blocking you, third card representing advice. If you'd like to get in line for a reading, we do have a line open. It's at 800-930-2819. So let's get this party started. Nancy, welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
Good morning. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good.
Excellent.
I just got a lot on my mind.
Well, is there anything in particular you have a question about that you'd like some guidance on today?
I'm trying to finish my degree, and I want to finish it in the next 3 weeks. I have the last final project.
Okay, and I'm sorry, you're a little muffled. A little close to the microphone. Can you repeat what you said?
About that. Can you hear me? Is that better?
A little bit better. If you can just repeat what the situation is. Yep.
Okay. I'm on the final project for my master's degree, and I really, but I'm having a hard time focusing. I want to finish it in the next 3 weeks. Before the graduation ceremony.
Well, first of all, congratulations. That is fantastic. Well, let's take a look and see what is going on. So while you were talking, I pulled three cards, and let's take a look and see what we got here. Well, not surprising, your core card comes up as the Ten of Wands. Now, in this card, you have a person who has got a lot on their plate. Here you see a person who is, it's like, I can't think of a more perfect card. I love these cards. I don't know how it works, but I love the cards. It's like, it's just the right card for the situation. So you got this person who's got 10 wands, and he just because you can push something forward, it doesn't necessarily mean you should, meaning that just because you can do everything by a certain timeline, or just because you can do everything and then some, it can create a taxing situation on a mind, body, and spirit level. Because here, the person can easily, the person can move these 10 wands forward. But if you look at the picture of the 10 of wands, you see that in order for him to carry and push everything uphill, his shoulders are hunched over, meaning that it's becoming sort of a burden. It becomes heavy. Not only that, but in order for him to hold all 10 wands, his right hand is actually covering his eyes because he's got to grasp the wand on the other side. So what impact that has is that it actually can block the view of the destination, which then itself can be like a vicious cycle, making it be like, oh my God, where is this going to? How long is this going to last? Just by releasing just one thing from your either tangible to-do list right now or from your proverbial to-do list. Like if you call Aunt Betty every single Sunday, maybe for the next couple of weeks, we don't call her. You know, so just because it's like something I feel like I got to do, ask yourself what you can let go of. Just releasing one thing. Just, it's amazing how just one thing, if you're carrying your groceries, you just release the one can. It makes it so much easier. But from a universe perspective, it also becomes more clear where it's going. And then you're not creating that vicious cycle. Does that resonate so far?
Yes, it does. That's what it feels like.
Excellent. You know, so often when we're just like trying to finish a race up, we're like, okay, I don't want anything to stop. I'm just going to keep doing everything that I've been doing. And it's like, no, we know you can do it. you don't have to prove your talents, your worth. You don't have to prove or justify any of your actions to anyone but yourself. And so let's just drop one thing off the plate. Now, something challenging or blocking you is the Moon card. So it's interesting because both the Moon card and the Ten of Wands highlight the fact that one of the things that's kind of counterintuitively or rather unconsciously adding some weight, which can lead to some stress, is not knowing the end destination. Because in the Moon card, you've got these two dogs or wolves, I call them like the duality of energy, left brain, right brain, yin and yang, masculine, feminine. And they're trapped between a desert, they're trapped on a desert island between two very distinct places. First is the past, which is represented by this lobster attempting to get up onto the shore. And while that looks threatening, it's the thing that you can see the most clearest. So the brain's like, oh, no, I don't want to go backwards. But then on the other side, you see this windy path where you can't see the end destination. Well, that looks scary, particularly when you have been so laser focused on getting to this part of the race, getting to this part of this journey, that now it can be a little bit on that unconscious level. There's that feeling of like, ooh, but now we start facing, now that the race is coming to a close, we start facing the fact that we don't know where the heck this whole journey is leading. That can be a little bit tense in the body. However, know that you take your brain with you to navigate each part of the way. The more you focus so heavily on what that end destination is, the more you may miss some of those glorious detours, those twists, those turns, and also those unexpected serendipitous joys that are to the universe is just laying on your path. So it's an interesting thing so far because they're both about this not able to see that end destination. Does that make sense so far?
It does. Yeah, I'm feeling, I've been very scattered. It's hard to focus because of that. Not knowing where it's going.
And, you know, I always say I'm a type A control freak. 99% of my clients are type A control freaks. I speak the language. I understand. I'm like, once I got that goal, I'm like shooting through there no matter what the strain. I always say, you know, okay, once I get there, I'll chill out. I'll enjoy. And this is a reading saying. Yeah, I mean, this is a reading saying when you are thirsty, you are already dehydrated. So take this time now, release stuff, even though we all know that you could do it with holding on to keep doing some stuff, release it anyway. Yeah. And that's the hard thing for control freaks. And I say that with total love and respect as I am one myself, because we don't want to release something because then it shows some sort of weakness. But it's like, who are we, you know, who are we doing this for? We're doing this for you and you alone. Release it. Even though you can do it, this is causing that kind of weightedness. The advice is the Empress. Love this card because this card, again, is also about the fact that you don't know what the end destination is all about. But this card, the Empress card is all about creativity and growth. But it is done in a very distinct way. Here, rather than pushing something forward just because she can, the Empress is just sitting back on her throne. She's surrounding herself with the growth and harmony of the environment, things that can make her feel joyous and happy and cheerful. She's giving to herself the nutrients that she needs in order to allow things to grow and develop. Now, here's the part that I was mentioning about. She's pregnant. Now, this as an advice card is not saying go get pregnant necessarily, but I want you to think of the fact that a pregnancy is something that you create, you feed, you water, you rub the belly, you talk to it, you sing, you know, all those things, but you can't control it. It will develop in ways that you have no power over, and yet once you can relax into that, the end result can exceed any and all expectations. If you're only going to feed and water and eat and drink and all those things to give the baby fuel, only if it comes out with blonde hair, it's again creating that taxing stress. Let the journey unfold. You are just getting started. Release what you can now, even though we all know that you can do it regardless. That's okay. But still release it. Note how the body feels. Give yourself permission to be okay with not knowing the outcome. Enjoy the journey. This is such a trite phrase, but it's not the destination. It's the journey. But that should be your motto. I hope that was helpful for you.
It is helpful. It's very helpful. It makes me laugh because it is hard to release things, and I want what I want, but
absolutely,
it's very helpful.
It is hard to do it, but do it anyway.
Okay.
Excellent. I'm so glad it was helpful. Congratulations on going through this race, and you're doing it great. Just stay on the journey. Don't worry about the end destination. The end destination will happen, but it'll happen in ways that exceed your expectations. Please keep us updated, okay?
I sure will. Thank you so much.
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks so much for calling. Well, we're going to take our last break. When we come back, we've got more readings. Susan, hang tight. You're listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. We'll be right back.
There's a bridge and there's a river that I still must cross as I'm going on my journey. Though I might be lost, and there's a road I have to follow.
Tune in to Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly Neff. This hit show will illuminate your senses and empower you beyond your daily stressors and hardships. Renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly will captivate you with far-reaching topics and amazing guests as you wake to the greatest version of yourself. Learn to tap into your intuitions, think critically about our world, heal emotional and psychological wounds, and follow your passions to live your dreams. The Lucid Planet. Welcome home. Visit lucidplanetradio.com for more information.
Integrate spirituality into your everyday lives on Universe Soul Heart Radio. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio as Kathleen Johnson explores the concept of sensible spirituality, keeping you grounded, connected, and centered on the path to wholeness. Kathleen has dedicated her life to facilitating holistic healing and wholeness in others. Listen to Universe Soul Heart Radio and learn how to flourish, grow, and impact all we do on planet Earth. For more information, go to universesoulheart.net.
Amber Teal, founder of The Healthy Edge, is bringing you the hit show Healthy Edge Radio, living with power, passion, and purpose. Amber provides the support and tools necessary for you to finally release the weight and emotions that are hidden beneath the weight. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information on how you can take the next step with Amber, visit GetTheHealthyEdge.com.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Have you ever wondered if there's a way to heal the deep, hidden inner issues, wounds, beliefs, and traumas? The Journey into Spiritual Healing engages people in all areas of their lives to heal themselves and others. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio as Dr. Jaffe brings conversations of healing of body, mind, and spirit as he merges the excellence of traditional medicine with the beauty of spiritual healing. For more information about Dr. Jaffe, this show, and his work, visit drjaffemd.com.
Conscious Confidence Radio, a timeless wisdom with Sarah Maine. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio and join Sarah on an adventurous journey to the deeper level of meaning to move beyond today's world of constant change, confusion, and uncertainty beyond the shadow of fear. This hit show explores key concepts such as confidence, values, and attitude in a dynamic way. To learn more about Sarah and her work, visit sarahmaine.com. But when I get there, I know, 'cause I'm taking it.
Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. You can learn more about me if you're interested in booking an intuitive tarot card session over phone or Skype worldwide, or for an event nationwide on my website directly there at elitetarot.com. That's ElitetarotE.com or MainstreamMetaphysicsRadio.com. So we had a caller. Unfortunately, she dropped off. Come back, Susan. So until she comes back, I just thought I would finish up what I was talking about in terms of tarot and all about what goes into tarot. And so it talked about how the basic tarot deck is laid out. So I wanted to go into a little bit about where does this thing come from? And here is the short answer. Your guess is as good as mine. No one really knows for sure where it started. Some say China, some say Egypt. I've heard every single thing in the book. We do suspect that the name tarot comes from a card game, and the card game was called Tarocchi from Italy, and it had 78 cards, including 22 trump cards, just like bridge. In the 15th century, that's where we see the first official tarot card deck, which we know of, and it was created for the Duke of Milan in Italy. And then in the 18th century, occultist Antoine Court de Gobelin updated the deck. Now we jump forward even more to 1910. And in 1910, mystic Arthur Edward Waite, and you may, that may sound familiar because I use the Rider-Waite tarot card deck, but in 1910, mystic Arthur Edward Waite redesigned the deck yet again and commissioned the artist Pamela Coleman Smith, who is a bit of a tarot icon in the tarot community, to create pictures of the major arcana and to create for the very first time pictures of the minor arcana. Anyway, Waite published the book, The Pictorial Key to the Tarot, which you can read word for word today, although I gotta tell you, I have read this book and it is a challenging read, but good luck. So the Rider-Waite tarot card deck, it's the most fundamental deck out there. It's the deck I use, and so many other decks are based on the Rider-Waite deck. In fact, there are hundreds and hundreds of different kinds of decks, different genres, anything from Real Housewives tarot, steampunk tarot, gummy bears tarot, too many for me to mention. People always ask, well, what is the best deck for me to use if I'm just starting out doing tarot? And I always say that the Rider-Waite is such a good starter deck just because you've got all the resources out there. However, the very best deck for you is actually the deck that you relate most to. So when you actually get your deck out for the first time, you know, go to a store, check out the different ones. Which deck calls to you? Do you like the images? Do you feel something? Can you tell the story just from looking at the images? Again, I always say I do not really work with stock interpretations. I really just use the images to let that trigger my own intuition, because tarot is an intuitive art. So let those images trigger that intuition and then tell the story. Let those cards be that way forward. So it may be a deck that you might surprise you, but if it relates well to you, then go for it. If you're interested in terms of how do I use the deck for the first time and I'm just learning tarot, I always say pull a card a day, just so you can start getting familiarized with the cards. However, a lot of times people will pull a card in the beginning of the day. This is horrible, because it's until you have your own kind of relationship with these 78 individual cards. If let's just say it's the morning and you pull your card and you get the Tower card or you get the Death card, then you're going to be presenting energy, kind of freaked out energy about what the day holds. And you might actually create kind of this turmoiled energy or look at something that's happening and make it kind of more severe than it is. Rather, don't do it at the beginning of the day. Pull a card at the end of the day. So let's just say you had a pretty easy going day. And then at the end of the day, you pull the Devil card. Now it's like, okay, well, how does this card that I'm pulling with its unique image, how does that relate to everything that I know happened in that day? Did you compromise? Did you make some sort of agreement that maybe wasn't honoring your own authenticity? Did you free or release yourself from some sort of compromise? Now we're having a much better and more authentic and unique interpretation of the Devil card. Let's just say at the same time, it was a turbulent day. And then when you pull your card at the end of the day, you get the Sun. Or you get something kind of banal and just really basic. And it's like, okay, well, how do I interpret this card in relationship to the day? Maybe the turbulence that I was feeling was actually dislodging things, or because I was exactly honoring myself in authenticity or not. Let the card tell the story post-day. This way, and what I do is, you know, you can also kind of keep a little notebook. And so every day, just write down what your card you pulled at the end of the day and how it interpreted, and just a few words, you don't have to write a book on it, and how it meant to or related in some way or didn't relate in some way to the day that you actually had. See if some cards come up more often than others. It's like, wow, I keep pulling the Ace of Swords. Why? Or some cards just don't show up. Oh, interesting. And then as you maybe do this for a couple of weeks, then go back to the days where it didn't make any sense and see if it suddenly made some sense because you formed your own connection, your own interpretation with the cards. Also, use your non-dominant hand when you pull a card. Again, as I said earlier, the non-dominant hand is the hand that accesses the unconscious. Now, as I always say, I'm a type A control freak, and that's that dominant hand. The dominant hand wants to pull the card. The dominant hand wants to steer the card. The dominant hand wants to unlock the door. You let the non-dominant hand pull the card. Now, while you're doing that, your brain might be saying, I don't know what I'm pulling. But it's like, okay, that's fine. So you pull the card with your non-dominant hand, write it down. Don't think, oh, I must have pulled the wrong card. Honor the card that you got. Find that interpretation from within and have fun with it. Use it in a way to provide you with guidance. And then you can start trying it out on others. But again, make sure everything that you're doing is done with the highest purpose, the highest good. And just use it as just yet one more tool in your ever-present cosmic tool chest. Oh my gosh, I could talk about tarot cards all day long, but alas, we're at the end of the show. Thank you, everyone, for tuning into our reading show on Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. Thank you, Benny, for running the show. Thank you, one and all, for tuning in. This is such a blessing for me to be able to do this show each week, and I look forward to next week's show, where I'll be doing readings all hour. So, please join me every Thursday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern, with peace and love and gratitude. See you back here next time.
With your host, Eve. Join us Thursdays at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com to harness the power of the universe for optimal success and happiness as Eve continues to take metaphysics mainstream. Until then, learn more about Eve and Elite Tarot at EliteTarot.com. That's EliteTarot.com. See you next week.
The preceding audio was via a Skype call.